Hello, today I'm going to review these low noise switching power supplies released by Daitron. Power supplies that emit little noise are mostly linear power supplies that use linear regulators. However, these Daitron low noise power supplies are switching power supplies. It sounds a bit contradictory. In this video, I'm going to see the potential of these low noise switching power supplies by analyzing their waveforms and also disassembling them. By the way, I attached the links of these low noise switching power supplies in the description. Please check them out. First, I'll briefly explain the difference between linear and switching power supplies. Firstly, a linear power supply. This is a common configuration of a linear power supply. This is a 50 or 60 Hz transformer, which is space consuming. Then there is a full wave rectifier circuit. After the current becomes DC, it is smoothed by an electrolytic capacitor. After that, a series regulator removes the ripple components that couldn't be removed by the electrolytic capacitor. Then an LC filter removes the ripple components even more. That's the structure of a linear power supply. At this point, it's still an AC waveform. After passing through the full wave rectifier, the current is rectified and the waveform becomes like this. This time, since an electrolytic capacitor is included, the waveform will be significantly smoothed. However, even after passing through the electrolytic capacitor, there are still some ripples that couldn't be removed. Such ripples are eliminated by the series regulator here. The input waveform of the series regulator contains some ripple voltage. The output waveform has no ripple voltage. After that, the current goes through the low-pass filter. The advantage of a linear power supply is that the output voltage is very clean and has little noise. However, there are disadvantages. Linear power supplies are large and heavy because the frequency of the transformer here is 50 or 60 Hz. The body is pretty heavy. The size of a transformer is larger when the frequency is lower. Also, the loss at the series regulator is large. Because of that, the heat sink for heat dissipation needs to be large. Next, let's look at this common configuration of switching power supplies. Here is the utility power. It's an AC with a frequency of 50 or 60 Hz. Firstly, the current is rectified by the full wave rectifier circuit. Then it's smoothed by the capacitor. After that, switching is performed by the power semiconductor. Switching is a significant important role of a switching power supply. Depending on the power supply class, the switching frequency varies from several 10 to several 100 kHz. The time length of the horizontal axis of the input waveform and output waveform are different. The input frequency is about 50 or 60 Hz. On the other hand, as for the output AC voltage, the frequency is several 100 kHz. The high frequency switching performed here allows the use of a smaller transformer. That's why switching power supplies are smaller than linear power supplies. At this point, the output current is still an AC, so the diode here converts it back to DC. Then the LC filter removes the noise and ripples to some extent, and the DC is output. I'll summarize the differences between linear and switching power supplies. A linear power supply converts an AC to DC once, and after that, the DC is not converted again. On the other hand, a switching power supply firstly converts an AC-DC, then converts the DC back into AC, and then converts the AC to DC again. Switching power supplies need to perform more conversions, but their size is usually smaller compared to linear power supplies when the rated power is the same. It's because their AC transformer operates at high frequencies. Therefore, switching power supplies have an advantage that they are smaller than linear power supplies. On the other hand, there's a disadvantage. It's the electromagnetic noise generated because of switching. The switching noise appears in the output voltage as well. I'll go into details about this switching noise later. However, there is a way to reduce the switching noise, soft switching. This Daitron power supply uses an LLC converter, which allows soft switching operation. If you use such circuits that allow soft switching and use a particular controlling method, soft switching can be achieved. Adopting soft switching techniques suppresses the noise generation itself, which makes the power supply low noise. Daitron's low noise power supply, which I'm holding in my hand right now, has a small body because it's a switching power supply. And yet, it keeps the noise low by adopting soft switching that generates less noise. What is more, it uses linear power supply circuits to suppress the noise even further. Simply put, it's a hybrid of a linear power supply and a switching power supply. I'll disassemble this power supply later in this video. I'll show you the actual circuit then. Now let's look at the lineups of these low noise switching power supplies. There are four types of switching power supplies. There is a 50 watt ultra low noise switching power supply, and there are 50, 150 and 300 watt low noise power supplies. As for the output voltage, each type has 5 to 48 volt versions. This voltage variety is the same as typical industrial switching power supplies. I've been talking about noise suppression so far, but there are several types of noises. There are conducted noise, radiated electromagnetic noise, and ripple voltage in the output voltage. In this video, we will look at the ripple voltage and the output voltage. On the product website, the ripple voltage in the output voltage of the low noise power supply is 10 millivolts. As for the ultra low noise power supply, it's 1 millivolt. It's quite low. The ripple voltage of a linear power supply manufactured by TDK is about 1 millivolt. It means the ultra low noise power supply's catalog spec is the same as the linear power supply. I heard from a Daitron representative that their low noise power supplies use soft switching techniques to reduce noise. Their ultra low noise power supply also uses soft switching techniques, but in addition, it uses circuits that are used in linear power supplies. Therefore, the ripple voltage of the ultra low noise power supply is even smaller. Now I'm going to actually see how much ripple voltage is in the output voltage using an oscilloscope. Using this setup, I'm going to measure the ripple voltage in the output voltage. For this measurement, I used this 8-ohm resistor as a load. At first, I used an electronic load, but I ended up measuring the noise from the electronic load as well, so I decided to use this resistor instead. For comparison, I prepared a common switching power supply. This is the low noise switching power supply. This is the ultra low noise switching power supply. Before measurement, let's check the noise of the oscilloscope itself. This is the noise floor of the oscilloscope. The RMS noise is about 60 microvolts. Peak-to-peak noise is about 500 microvolts. Firstly, let's measure the common switching power supply. This is the output voltage waveform of the common switching power supply. The waveform has ups and downs. There are switching ripple components. Look at this part. Let's zoom in. This is caused by the switching noise. The noise affects the output voltage. The RMS value of the output voltage ripple is about 6.7 millivolts. The peak-to-peak value is about 95 millivolts. This power supply is not specifically advertised as a low noise power supply, so some noise ripples are generated. I think it's a standard amount. When this voltage with the switching ripple and noise is supplied to a load, the load is directly affected by the ripple and noise. Next, let's look at the low noise power supply. There. The displayed range is the same as earlier when we measured the common power supply, but the noise is much smaller. I can barely see the noise. Let's zoom in vertically. There. After zooming in, the noise ripple components finally became visible. This waveform is unstable, but you can make it stable by zooming out on the time axis. You can see a ripple component of 100 Hz, twice the AC line frequency. This is the low frequency component that couldn't be removed by the switching power supply. It is quite difficult to remove this kind of ripple component by controlling the switching power supply. The RMS of this output voltage ripple is about 700 microvolts. The peak to peak is about 4 millivolts. When you zoom in on the time axis to adjust to the switching frequency, the RMS is approximately 200 microvolts, and the peak to peak value is 1.4 millivolts. It's pretty good. Next is the theme for today, the ultra low noise power supply. Let's do it. The waveform has barely changed since turning on the power. I'll increase the amplitude. The noise is very low. When the amplitude increases, the radio waves emitted by my wireless microphone are displayed. This is when the microphone is off. When I turn it on, there, it affects a lot. If you move the microphone away, it doesn't have so much influence. But after all, it does have some influence, so I'll use a lapel microphone for this measurement. I'm not measuring in an anechoic chamber, so noises from environmental factors are picked up. This is the waveform when the power supply is turned off. When you turn it on, the waveform becomes like this. There's not so much difference from before turning on the power supply, so this measurement is difficult. With the previous low noise power supply, we saw ripples around the AC line frequency. But with this ultra low noise power supply, it's almost invisible. The undulating waveform displayed right now is derived from the environment. Even after turning off the power supply, you can still see the same ripples. It's difficult to eliminate this. The RMS of the ripples around the AC line frequency is about 130 microvolts, 1.8 millivolts peak to peak. I changed the display mode to histogram. The RMS voltage ripple is about 120 microvolts. The peak-to-peak value is about 1.3 millivolts. Let's look at other types of noises. Firstly, conducted noise. I don't have the equipment to measure it, so I'll show you the noise graphs provided by Daitron. Firstly, this is the graph of a common switching power supply. The noise is within the standard, but there is still some conducted noise. This is another manufacturer's linear power supply. As expected of a linear power supply, there is almost no conducted noise. The graph is quite flat. This is Daitron's low noise power supply. There are peaks at around 150 to 200 kHz. At higher frequencies, there are no peaks, just like the linear power supply. This may be thanks to the circuit design, including soft switching and the noise filter. The same goes for the ultra-low noise power supply. There are peaks at 150 to 200 kHz, but at higher frequencies, the graph is similar to the linear power supply. If you want to look in detail, pause the video here. As for the radiated noise, Daitron products are almost the same as the linear power supply. However, both of the Daitron power supplies have peaks that are not present in the linear power supply graph. As for the output common mode current, the linear and ultra-low noise power supplies have almost the same waveforms. On the other hand, the low noise power supply has some common mode current flows, but it's much smaller than that of the common switching power supply. I also measured the efficiency. This is ultra-low noise power supply. The maximum efficiency is 80%. Considering the efficiency of the common switching power supply is around 90%, the efficiency of the ultra-low noise power supply is a little low. This is due to the circuit inside. I'll have a look later. However, it is still significantly more efficient than a linear power supply, because linear power supplies usually operate at around 50 or 60% efficiency. Next, I'll give you an idea about where to use these low noise power supplies. When the noise on the power supply voltage is not a problem, it's better to use a common switching power supply. Using a low noise power supply, where it is not necessary, only increases the cost. However, some devices require the application of low noise power supplies. For example, devices with signal amplification features and precision control features, such as electron microscopes. I'll explain using an electron microscope as an example. The electron gun here produces an electron beam. These lenses and electrodes change the width and direction of the beam. Low noise power supplies are used here. They supply power to the lenses and electrodes. Semiconductor manufacturing equipment also control electron beams. Many devices require low noise power supplies. This is a comparison of microscope image quality. A normal switching power supply is used for the left. Daitron's low noise power supply is used for the right. If the supplied voltage or current contains ripples and noises, the output image becomes blurry. Low noise switching power supplies can help output clear images. This means that linear power supplies are replaceable with these low noise power supplies. Other than precision control, signal amplifier circuits are one of the main usages of low noise power supplies. A power supply supplies power to the op-amp. If the power supply generates noise in the process, power with noise is supplied, and the noise is output from the op-amp and sometimes even amplified. In such cases, you can replace the power supply to a low noise one. Precision position control requires low noise power supplies as well. They are necessary for galvoscanners, for example, when ultra-precise position control is required. A low noise power supply is used to rotate these motors. By using a low noise power supply here, the influence from the power supply noise can be reduced to almost zero. You have problems with the noise from the power supply. The noise from the power supply interferes with the performance of your device. You can't use a linear regulator because of the space constraints. In such cases, please try this low noise power supply or ultra low noise power supply. You can also use these when the linear power supply you're using became discontinued. As we've seen so far, the performance of these power supplies is so high, they are replaceable with linear power supplies. So far, I've been introducing applications in industrial field, but recently these power supplies are gaining attention from the audio industry as well. This low noise audio power supply released by AliExpress utilizes the technology of Daitron. This power supply's performance is just as good as a linear power supply. Please check it out. Now I'll disassemble the power supplies. The main part of the video finally starts. I'm going to disassemble and check the circuits inside to understand how this power supply achieves low noise. I'm going to disassemble this ultra-low noise power supply, RFS50A. The representative of Daitron told me that this product's design philosophy is to reduce the noise generation itself. One of the common noise reduction measures in power supplies is to implement noise suppression components, such as inductors and capacitors, to decrease the amount of noise that is already generated. However, this power supply was designed with the aim of reducing the amount of noise to be generated. Instead of taking a reactive approach to already generated noise, it prevents the noise generation itself. Here is a block diagram of the power supply configuration. I want to explain about the primary circuit so the secondary circuit is omitted. The circuit configuration is quite simple. An LC input filter, a full wave rectifier circuit with a diode, a power factor correction circuit, a series regulator, and an LLC converter. From the diagram, we can see that both switching power supply and series regulator are used. The key to achieving low noise is the use of these series regulator and LLC converter. It's because the LC resonance system of the LLC converter allows soft switching. Soft switching can achieve low noise power conversion. However, low frequency ripple around 50 Hz cannot be eliminated by an LLC converter. For this reason, a series regulator is installed between the PFC circuit and the LLC converter in order to remove the low frequency ripple components around the AC line frequency. Let's have a look at the operation waveform. The yellow waveform on the left is the input current of the power supply. The red waveform is the output voltage of the PFC circuit. The blue waveform is the voltage after passing through the series regulator. The PFC circuit starts to operate at the point indicated by the arrow. It boosts the DC voltage from 140 volts to 400 volts. After the boost is complete, the waveform changes. The LLC converter starts working at the point indicated by the arrow. When the LLC converter starts operating, a ripple component with twice the frequency of the AC power line appears in the output voltage of the PFC circuit. This happens in principle. A series regulator is not implemented on the low noise power supply, so the output voltage waveform still contains the ripple component with twice the frequency of the AC power line. In the case of the ultra low noise power supply, a series regulator is implemented to eliminate this ripple voltage. This is the enlarged waveform. After passing through the PFC circuit, the ripple voltage still remains. But after passing through the series regulator, the ripple voltage is eliminated. This configuration removes the ripple component with twice the frequency of the AC power line. Also, the LLC converter reduces the switching ripple by performing soft switching. This is how they achieve low noise. By the way, the operating range of an LLC converter is quite narrow, so it's difficult to operate an LLC converter at the optimal operating point. I checked if the operating range of the LLC converter is widened by controlling the DC voltage supplied to the converter, but it seems the input voltage is not controlled. It's stable at around 400 volts. So I've been reviewing the low noise power supplies released by Daitron. They are quite interesting in that they are switching power supplies, and yet their noise suppression level is as high as linear power supplies. By looking into the circuit configuration, we found that an LLC converter is used to reduce the switching noise as much as possible, and a linear regulator is used to reduce the low frequency ripple components. Lastly, I strongly recommend these products for the following cases. First, you are having trouble with the noise emitted from the power supply. Second, the noise from your power supply negatively affects the performance of the circuit. Third, you want to use a linear regulator, but cannot do so because of the space constraints. Or the linear regulator you're currently using became discontinued. There are links in the description. If this video was helpful, please comment, like, and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching.